Welcome back. The National Skill Development Corporation signed a memorandum of understanding with the Directorate of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Government of Goa, in the presence of Skill Development Minister Vishwajit Rane. Under this memorandum, an international skill hub will be set up in the state to provide skills in healthcare and tourism and hospitality. This hub will empower youth of Goa to be ready for the emerging job opportunities in the country. The institute also aims to provide international placements to local candidates through programs like Technical Intern Training Program and India International Skills Centers.
The campus will be set up at Heritage Building, Old Azilo Hospital at Mapsa, North Goa. Training for marginalized groups will be imparted under Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana besides market-led fee-based schemes.
All of us know healthcare is playing a very important role in today's time. COVID-19 has changed our thinking process and pattern. And as a result of the shortage of various type of technical staff in the healthcare sector, like the paramedical technicians, you have the dialysis, radiographic technicians, ECT technicians, though we have colleges of allied sciences here in the state of Goa, we still find there's a tremendous shortage in order to fight the pandemic in the state of Goa. Dr. Tiyan sir, I would like to draw your attention that as far as Goa is concerned, with the help of the Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji, we are in the process now of inaugurating in another month or two, which will be handed over the largest hospital under the Prime Minister's Pradhan Mantri Swasthya Suraksha Yojana, which is a 500-bedded hospital with the state-of-art facilities, where we have spent something like close to around 450 crores, which will be an e-hospital. And these are the type of hospitals that we have put up. We have got four hospitals which are in the pipeline to be commissioned and which are state-of-art hospitals. So looking at this and talking about PPP on several other areas, we have also partnered with public-private partnership to take various initiatives forward. And as a result of which, we thought when we are talking about skill development, then Jyoti ji did mention, yes, on several occasions I have mentioned, is that it's very difficult. It's easy to get a northeastern person here to cook for you Goan food, or you have somebody from Orissa, or you have somebody from other states coming into the state of Goa and helping us. But finding a traditional or looking after these traditional areas of finding people to do things that are traditionally, which used to be done earlier, is very difficult and is becoming more and more difficult. Jyoti ji, I would like to draw your attention, and M.N. Pandey ji is also a witness, is that for the support that he has been giving us, and today, as far as Goa is concerned, we are in the process of tying up with EHL Switzerland, which is one of the top hospitality institutes, and also CIA is helping us bring this relation and take this relationship forward. And as a result of which, we thought that we should use the PPP model and the way and the thinking of the Honorable Prime Minister Pandeyji and the Skill Development Ministry, Government of India, in order to achieve these objectives, so that we are able to not only create a workforce and a workforce that is only employable in Goa. Why should we look at somebody who has to be employed only in Goa? Instead, we should be globally employable. And as a result of which, in today's time, in today's pandemic, we talk about job losses, we talk about jobs being lost on a regular basis, but same time, that gives you an opportunity to create that type of workforce which we can replace and upskill them and place them in positions that are going to be available. And as a result of which, as you mentioned, that there's a skill gap analysis, as we discussed, we have already in the process of finalizing an agency to help us do the skill gap analysis and help us see. And Goa must be the only state where we have taken CII on board to help us drive industry and policy to take it forward.
Bureau Report Prime.